People serve money in banks in case of an emergency. Genetic banks have a similar purpose for scientists to conserve rare plants and animals. Researchers can withdraw samples from these genie banks to help rebuild populations of animal breeds to help increase genetic diversity within species.
My name is Dr. Charles Lagu, the Executive Director, National Animal Genetic Resource Center and Data Bank. I'm the National Coordinator for Animal Genetic Resources for the Republic of Uganda, but also the host for the regional bank for the Eastern Africa, for the Gene Bank, for the regional Gene Bank.
Uganda has been chosen by the African Union to host the regional Gene Bank for the Eastern Africa region. The regional bank is housed at the National Animal Genetic Resources Center and Data Bank. Magrick.
We are hosting 12 countries, and this includes the countries Uganda is the host. We have Kenya, we have Tanzania, we have Burundi, we have Rwanda, we have Ethiopia, Djibouti, Eritrea, Somalia, we have Comoros, we have Sudan and South Sudan. Now, the essence of this Eastern Africa Regional Gene Bank is to conserve threatened indigenous animal genetic resources and those which are on the verge of extinction. We launched this on the 19th of July at Entebbe at the Livestock Experimental Station. And this is a gene bank for the region, 12 countries, supported under the African Union and the Bureau of Animal Genetic Resources, of course funded by the European Union. And this is being managed under an arrangement spearheaded by ASERECA, the East African Community, IGAD, and of course the member states.
The genetics project has facilitated us in several aspects in order to be able to conserve the genetics of indigenous animals in the region. It has donated us several equipment in addition to capacity building. We have got equipment to help in characterization of the animals, because we must clearly know what we are collecting and what we are conserving. So in here we are in the genomics laboratory where we do extraction of DNA. We have an automatic DNA extractor. Then we do real-time PCR. We can also do the conventional PCR and have the DNA, then use it to do characterization of the animals after collecting.
Among the collections for keeping animal genetics for thousands of years, we also use semen. Now, where we are in this room, we have the equipment that help us to collect semen from animals, package it, and freeze it for it to be available even 1,000 years from now. This machine you see here is a semen packaging machine. I'm sure in the field you might have been taken through on how to collect semen from different species, cattle, goats, pigs, and all that. So once that semen is collected, it is packed in the straws, and the straws are packed from this machine. Now, the other machine is the machine that prints on the straw. In order for you to store and be able to retrieve, there must be information. You must be able to know that this straw was from this animal that was collected from such and such a location and things like that. Then we also have a machine that helps us to freeze the semen that has been put into the straws. You are aware that in order for the semen to be kept for thousands of years, it must be kept at negative 196 degrees Celsius. So the process of getting the semen from the body temperature, the room temperature of the body temperature of the animals, to that negative 196 is an elaborate process. So we also got that machine that helps us to store. Then we also have a minus 80 freezer, which helps us to store samples of different categories for a medium period of time, like a year or two. And these samples include, we call them somatic cell samples, tissue, blood, serum, DNA, name it. Then once these have been, once the semen has been frozen, it is stored in the liquid nitrogen tanks, which I'm sure you've seen.
Our capacity was enhanced to be able to conduct multiple ovulation, which is a technology of injecting female animals like cows with the hormones to enhance, to ensure that they produce several eggs. Usually they produce one in a month, to ensure that they produce over 40 eggs or more. And then these eggs are flushed out of their reproductive system, and then they are brought to this lab. When they come to this lab under this microscope, we can scan through and pick the eggs, and the eggs, or actually the embryos, actually we can now process them, pack them in the straws we can see here, and after packing them into the straws, we can freeze them in the cooling system we see behind there, and store it in liquid nitrogen for so many years to be used later when needed. Or we can actually go ahead and use it straight away. The advantage with this technology of embryo transfer is that you can have one female that is the best cow you have around, and you can use it to produce so many calves that are as good as herself. Usually a female naturally produces one calf, but with this technology, this female can produce several calves in a year. So this helps us to take advantage of the genetic superiority of the best few animals we have.
I want to talk about the sustainability of the regional gene bank. We discussed this in the sixth steering committee meeting. We agree that members will make contribution, and the steering committee have leadership. Currently, I'm the chair of the steering committee for the next 2 years, and the vice chair of the steering committee is the representative from Burundi, and the second vice chair of the steering committee is a representative from Sudan. But before I chaired, our predecessor was the national coordinator for animal genetic resources from Ethiopia. So we agreed in a very transparent and very honest way to mobilize resources from member countries, which will help to facilitate. We have also agreed that we'll build the capacity of member countries. So member countries will be stationed at the gene bank in a very organized, systematic way, and they will also be able to develop research facilitated by Asereka, facilitated by ESC, which will be a basis to generate resources, human, financial, equipment, and other logistics to facilitate this initiative. But we are also going to go into massive drive from philanthropists, from good well wishers and so forth, to mobilize resources massively, and then we are able to put this in terms of research and development to sustain the gene bank operations. So in terms of sustainability, that is how we are looking at it, and we are also going to look at how the animal genetic resources that are of value can be developed and have market niche, product niche that market friendly, that can then be able to boost the private sector in terms of sustaining this genetic resource. So in essence, that is our strategy to sustain the gene bank operations.
The Ugandan Center will serve 12 countries, namely the 6 countries of East African Community: Sudan, Eritrea, Somalia, the Republic of Comoros, Ethiopia, and Djibouti.